look at the warnings over St. Louis. And all along this line, remember we had reports of a frontal cloud here that was over Frontenac. All along this line, we could see a spin up in a tornado. We haven't heard anything recently from that line. So that is some good news. And we still have that area, that kind of isolated cell that's merging with the line. And that is kind of just to the southwest of Edwardsville. So here's Edwardsville, just to the southwest. This is a storm cell that rode up the Mississippi River, basically. And now moved a little bit east of north and is very, very close to Edwardsville, has a history of rotation. Does not have a history of putting down a tornado. That's some real good news. Does not have a history of producing any damage. But you've got a rotating storm that could produce a tornado at any moment.
I made your screen very messy there, Steve, just to point out that there are actually two separate tornado warnings here. There's the one that we've been tracking for some time now on the southwest side of Edwardsville. And there's this other one where there's some concern around Frontenac about the possibility of some rotation. So two separate areas of rotation to be concerned with here.
I'll tell you what, let's, and
a new tornado warning just popped up. Sorry for interrupting, but from Edwardsville up to Warden. So
okay.
That's a continuation of a track of that storm that passed right through downtown St. Louis, just on the east side.
Let's do two things for folks in the St. Louis Metro. Let's start looping this. And what I want to do, Matt, is track first this line that's coming in.
Okay.
And it does look like it's moving more east, doesn't it?
It does.
Okay, so let's track the line. And then secondly, let's track that storm that still has the potential to produce a tornado near Edwardsville, because that has just had a brand new tornado warning. So we'll track that squall line there through, I mean, it's pretty much into St. Louis right now.
We had a report of a tornado it's a public report, Fairmont City in St. Clair County.
So that's going to be that storm that's riding up western portions of St. Clair County, moving into Madison. How long ago was that report?
It came in at 4:57, 1 minute ago.
4:57, okay. So right now, first things first, what we've done is we've tracked that line that's coming into St. Louis. So this line right here, there's some of the cities in the path of the storm, that particular storm. That doesn't mean you're not going to get hit by something first.
Actually, it's worth noting that cell south of O'Fallon, Illinois, is going to get a lot of people in this track box wet before the estimated time of arrival, because we're tracking that stronger squall,
Yeah. Just
catching up to the river now.
So what Matt's talking about is this storm cell right here, and that actually... Let's stop that loop and see where that newest tornado warning is. That's that cell.
I just gave Matt the text on that.
I think it is. See the hook?
Oh, yes. Yeah.
See that hook?
Yeah.
So why don't we first look at that new tornado warning in southern St. Clair County, and then we'll go up to that storm cell that I promised we would track. You know what? Before we do that, let's just zoom out. Let's get the big picture here. Because it's coming up on 5 o'clock. A lot of people usually tune in and expect the 5 o'clock news here on News 4. What you're going to get is live storm load coverage. We are continuing as we have all afternoon long. So 5 o'clock coming up here in just about 45 seconds. And we're going to continue with our coverage because of numerous tornado warnings. Some of them have already done damage earlier today in areas like Silex, Missouri, northwest of Troy, Missouri, near Montgomery City, Missouri, and now the most recent, which still could be producing damage coming through St. Genevieve County. It produced some damage near Fredericton. I'm Chief Meteorologist Steve Templeton. It's coming up on 5 o'clock. We'll continue with the live storm load coverage. If you need to head to the basement, we want you to know that we are streaming this live on KMOV.com. If you go to our homepage, there's going to be a great, big, bright red box that's flashing. It says live video. You click on there, and you'll get this live radar analysis. So you can grab the laptop, head to the basement. Maybe you have a computer in the basement. You can follow this. Maybe you're at work. It's 5 o'clock, and I've already asked some people, nasty, but I suggested that those people in Edwardsville, they kind of hold off on leaving work because of a strong storm moving through. So if you're at work, you can watch online. So on the left-hand side of our screen, Joe, what are we looking at? This is north of Fairmont City, Russell Kinsall. He's approaching Interstate 70. He tracked this storm when it first produced a wall cloud. We now have reports of a tornado on the ground in Fairmont City.
Right through the city of St. Louis.
And he's on the phone with us. What did you see, Russell?
We've been following this system from behind it and watched as continually parts of the clouds descend and whirl and then go back up and down. It's almost as if it's like wisps of cotton candy that are dancing around independent of the rest of the clouds, just on their own, moving up, down, spinning. large sections and then small sections. So it's outside of this system. It doesn't have much rain at all. That in a lot of play to it, there's a lot of movement in the clouds. We have not seen as large a section as we saw near South County Mall earlier that descended through the clouds, but there's no doubt the reports you've gotten about funnel clouds near Fairmont City and other places are coming from this particular system and are exactly what we've been following.
Thanks, Russell. Just to back that up, too, Kristen just handed to me a couple of reports from about 2 miles east of Granite City. Of course, that's in Madison County, Illinois. Numerous reports, the Weather Service is telling us, of a funnel cloud about a third of the way to the ground. So we can't call it a tornado. It's not in contact with the ground. But just east of Granite City, when we're seeing tight rotation on the radar, numerous reports of a funnel cloud about a third of the way to the ground.
So that rotation would be over Glen Carbon right now and headed towards Edwardsville. This is what I was talking about, where the line pushing in from the west is going to take it a little bit more to the northeast. So it was kind of headed more north, and now the line that's coming from the west, and I'm highlighting right here in this area, is most likely that rotation is going to be coming right up to Edwardsville. You can switch me over back to just the still radar there, man. I appreciate it. And so what I want to do is take it from this area and show you that we've got that pitch down here, right around Glen Carbon. Those folks in Glen Carbon, Edwardsville, need to be in the basement as this system comes through. Rotation, as Russell was saying, he's using Fairmont City, a little farther south of it. He's tracking it in a real good position, kind of twirling clouds, dancing down towards the ground, bouncing back up. The thing is, you just never know when that twirl is going to really touch it. And it's not going to bounce back up. And you've got a tornado on the ground for perhaps several minutes, and it could do some damage.
And that's a process that can take less than a minute. I mean, you can go from the kind of video we've been showing you where it looks like it's ready, willing, and able to drop a tornado to an actual tornado in contact with the ground in less than a minute. We've seen proof of that out of the thunderstorms in southwestern Missouri, Oklahoma, and Kansas over the last few days.
How about this? New Athens, just to the northeast of you. We've got tight rotation on the radar. This is one of our newer tornado warnings from in between New Athens and Fayetteville. It is headed over Highway 15. This is going to be southeast of Belgrade, and it's going to miss Belgrade. So if you're in the Scooterville, boy, Scott Air Force Base is probably scrambling right now. I gotta tell you. But that rotation is just northeast of New Athens, right here. If you're in the Belleville area right here, you're going to miss it. It's going to move sort of northeast. You want to draw a track on that.
Sure.
And I'll try and get the speed. By the way, we just got reports of 4.5-inch estimated, 4.5-inch baseball to softball-sized hail on the south side of the city.
We've got another one, Bobcat, a baseball-sized hail, South Compton Avenue in St. Louis.
Well, here's a picture over here.
It's about 20 minutes.
Well, I can come over here. Here's a picture we got in. Was sent in by a viewer. Look at that. Looks like several hailstones that kind of came together there, but it all came down as one big stone. Man, that's going to cause some damage.
Well, we appreciate that, number one. Number two, I hope you were inside when those things came down and you waited until the dangerous part of the storm passed.
I am inside, 2,000 miles away from this.
There's a ton of ways to stay in touch with us. Kristen Cornett is really doing a fantastic job keeping folks on our Facebook page updated. We're sending out tweets every time a new warning of any variety comes in. And let's get back to track right here. This is northeast at about 50, right?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to track what appears to be the tightest rotation here, which is probably somewhere just southeast of Freeburg. And I can tell you already I'm going to run out of screen, so hold on just a second. I'm going to zoom out a little bit and clear that off there. Zoom out a little bit.
Well, to do that, I'll just explain. We are looking at the Doppler winds. The greens are showing us winds that are inbound.